सचमुच में इस कार्यक्रम बहुत अच्छा और पवित्र कार्यक्रम है। इस कार्यक्रम में भाग लेने से मुझे मन में बहुत प्रसन्नता है और वो प्रसन्नता और भी बढ़ गया। दूर दराज के इलाका से, बस्तर से, जगदलपुर से, बीजापुर से, कोमटा से, छत्तीसगढ़ वहाँ से और तेलंगाना आंध्रा दोनों स्टेट से भी, सभी इलाका से वहाँ का प्रतिनिधि, वहाँ का अधिकारी, वहाँ का कर्मचारी, वहाँ का स्थानीय लोग भी इस कार्यक्रम में भाग ले रहे हैं। ये और भी प्रसन्नता का विषय है। और एक कार्यक्रम का विशेषता ये भी है, ये कार्यक्रम हमारा भारतीय जीवन पद्धति, हिंदू जीवन पद्धति में कहते हैं ना षष्ठी पूर्ति, इफ यू कंप्लीट 60 इयर्स षष्ठी पूर्ति, एंड देन दैट ऑल्सो इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन NMDC. NMDC माने नेशंस मेन डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन, दैट इज NMDC. ये कोई मामूली विषय नहीं है, इसलिए मैंने हाँ भर दिया जब मुझे रिक्वेस्ट किया भाई एक पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिट इतना साल काम करना और अच्छा काम करना, बहुत साल से उसमें कोई हड़ताल भी नहीं होना। हड़ताल माने काम का हड़ताल, पहले काम का हड़ताल होता है, बाद में फैक्ट्री का भी चाबी भी बंद होता है। हम लोगों ने अनुभव किया है, द पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिट्स वर एस्टैब्लिश इन द कंट्री वे बैक इन 50s 60s, कीपिंग इन यू द नीड फॉर रीजनल डेवलपमेंट एंड ऑल्सो एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन to create wealth in different parts of the country, whether it is Orissa, whether it is Chhattisgarh, whether it is Jharkhand, whether it is Andhra Pradesh, whether it is Telangana, BHEL, BHPV in Visakhapatnam, steel plant in Visakhapatnam or Salem. All these were aimed at creating and reducing the regional imbalances, giving push to the growth sector, and that too, these were all put by the government because at that time you did not have private money, this much money. Nowadays there is a lot of private money is coming, lot of foreign investment also is coming, those days. That's why the earlier rulers of the country, the Prime Minister Sri Jawaharlal Nehru and subsequently also, the focus was in creating industries, in creating public sectors in different parts of the country. Haridwar mein lagaya, kahan Haridwar, Salem mein lagaya. To ye uddesh wahi tha, magar baad mein जो स्थिति बन गया उसमें से हमको अवगत हो रहा है बहुत पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिट्स अच्छी तरफ काम नहीं कर पा रहे। क्यों? सोचना चाहिए। और सब लोग ये नेशनल मेन डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन का उदाहरण, सब लोग इसको स्वीकार करना चाहिए। इसलिए भाई बहुत आनंद महसूस कर रहा हूं आपका ये षष्ठी पूर्ति महोत्सव का, डायमंड जुबली सेलिब्रेशन का। मैंने सोचा डायमंड वगैरह वो ये शब्द हमारा नहीं है, बाहर का है, ये भी हमारा एक कमजोरी हो गया आजकल, हमारा भाषा में नहीं बोल सकते हम लोग, एक दूसरे से बात भी नहीं करते, घर में भी बात नहीं करते, हमारा भाषा में बोलना चाहिए। तो मैंने सोचा इसके लिए शब्दावली क्या हो सकता है डायमंड जुबली का, मैंने सोचा भाई इसका षष्ठी पूर्ति हो सकता है। षष्ठी पूर्ति संस्कृत में भी षष्ठी पूर्ति है, तेलुगु में भी षष्ठी पूर्ति है, मेरे ख्याल से हिंदी में भी षष्ठी पूर्ति होगा। 60 बेटर परफॉर्मिंग ईयर्स इन द लाइफ ऑफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, right from the minister, secretary, chairman, managing director to the lowest worker who have worked in this NMDC, they all deserve our congratulations. Mere aur se sabko abhinandan hai. Ek memorable occasion hai, this is an occasion to be remembered, to look back and also look forward. It's a person's life or an organization when the entity is doing well at this stage, creating immense value and spreading prosperity, it is indeed calls for celebrations. That's why aapka mantri ne itna bada karyakram ka ayojan kiya, mujhe Bharat ka uparashtrapati ko bulaya. Kyon? Ye keval NMDC ka nahi hai, keval ya abhi प्रयास कर रहे रमन सिंह जी, पूरा NMDC मेरा है, ऐसा लोगों को थोड़ा छत्तीसगढ़ के कारण से आगे बढ़ रहे थे। हाँ, छत्तीसगढ़ का योगदान जरूर है, इसमें कोई डाउट नहीं है, मगर साथ ही साथ देश का संपदा बढ़ाना, नेशंस मेन वेल्थ। आई वुड लाइक टू ब्रीफली हाईलाइट द इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्लेड बाई पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइज इन द कंट्रीज डेवलपमेंट नैरेटिव। द पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइजेस हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड इमेंसली टू द कंट्रीज इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ ओवर द ईयर्स। All the public sector enterprises have helped the country in building a sustained industrial base and technological competence in a number of areas. The PSEs have played a pioneering role in building the infrastructure, be it telecom, transportation, powers, irrigation, or road network, from manufacturing consumer goods like watches, scooters, to drugs. I don't know why they went to watches and scooters, and also they went to some hotels also. Aur hotels mein jab gaya, because I am of the firm opinion, the business of the government is not to do business. The government has to create infrastructure, provide the facilities. And then it took so many years. Then the former Prime Minister Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee came. Then he brought connectivity in the country, connectivity revolution, national highway, rural road, telecom, railway, national highway, rural highway, television connectivity, port connectivity, lot of connectivity revolution he brought in at that time. That's required. But the government, if it does it in business, nah, you manufacture scooters and starting trouble for the scooter. Then you manufacture biryani, we are talking of biryani. And then hotels, they are sinking, and you go to the people and tell them, sir, humne biryani banaya. Bikhnai rahi. Isliye thoda aapko tax dena padega. This is where we did some mistakes. The public sector should be for infrastructure, for the development of that area, and where you have core competence. Because we have seen some of the stories, drug manufacturing, and also hotels, and also scooters, and also films, and other things. But there are coal, oil, and natural gas are the other key areas where the public sector companies have made immense contribution to the national economy, achieving self-sufficiency, reducing the import to save precious foreign exchange, promoting exports, removing regional disparities to ensure balanced development, preventing monopolies in private sector, and providing employment were among the main objectives in establishing scores of PSEs across the country, minus the ones I have just now mentioned. To a large extent, many PSUs worked towards fulfilling these objectives and provided employment to lakhs of people. Of course, there are also public-owned companies which have failed to deliver the goods, and that is a different story altogether. So they have to introspect, and countries, political leadership also, policy makers also should introspect. What are the areas where we have core competence? Why we should focus, why we should invest, and what are the areas we leave it to the private people, other people. That should be the new thinking now. Friends, India is the country which is having 65% of the population below 35 years. This is a big demographic boon, and the energies of the young, educated population has to be fully harnessed to transform India into one of the leading economic powers in the world in the coming years. For this to happen, companies like NMDC must look beyond the conventional templates, take skilling programs for youth in a big way, and give thrust to Make in India initiative. I am happy that your minister has got a lot of ideas. As you are all aware, the story of NMDC set up in 15th November 1958 is woven around the dreamy hills and deep jungles lands of Bastar in Chhattisgarh, which is known as Dandakaranya from the epic periods. The entire area was brought to the mainstream of civilization by the spectacular effect of the effort of the NMDC by opening up mines in the year 1967. Today, Bhairav Jilla is a name to reckon with in the world iron ore market. NMDC, a pioneering exploration activity carried out for the development of iron ores in Karnataka and also in various regions like Kundremukh, Dhoni, Himalay, and then Baba Budan, Kumaraswamy, and Ramadurga, Karnataka, may be Horai. I am happy to note that NMDC is currently the largest iron ore mining company in India, with three highly mechanized iron ore complexes located in Chhattisgarh and Karnataka. It is also gratifying to note that NMDC diamond mining project Panna is the only mechanized diamond mine in Asia. I congratulate NMDC on posting a profit before tax 4,293 crores in the year 2017 and emerging as one of the top profit-making Navaratna public sector companies in the country. I am glad that NMDC has set up a dedicated exploring wing at Raipur, which will facilitate discovery of additional mineral wealth and lead to growth of the mining sector in the country. R&D efforts of many companies give an indication of its growth and substantiality and sustainability. The NMDC state-of-the-art R&D center at Hyderabad, declared as a center of excellence by UNIDO, can spur further growth in the sector. I am told that NMDC has also spread its footprint globally with the acquisition of reams of gold deposits in Tanzania, a majority stake in an iron ore deposit in Australia, and a cooking coal deposit in Mozambique, in partnership with two other public sector enterprises under the Ministry of Steel. I am very happy to know that NMDC is striving to invest in strategic and critical raw material which are required by our nation for long-term supply security. In line with this strategy, NMDC has already entered into MOUs with the Midhani and DMRL to explore opportunities for investment in tungsten mineral assets in India and abroad. Such initiatives will give impetus to Make in India program. Friends, as you are all aware, India is a mineral-rich country and produces 95% minerals. The mining industry in India typically contributes around 2.2 to 2.5% of India's overall GDP. This, I feel, is far below the potential of India's rich mineral resources, which have to be explored and fully tapped. For a country like India, the growth of core sectors like mining is highly significant because of its multiplier effect on the economy, leading to higher industrial production, creating a large number of jobs, and above all, leading to development infrastructure. I am told India is the second position in regards to chromite and barytes, while South Africa and China respectively possess the highest deposits of the two minerals. India is the third position as regards to coal and bauxite and ranked fourth globally as far as iron ore is concerned. The country today is on a high growth path and needs more steel raw material to build its infrastructure and strengthen its manufacturing base. There will be further demand for the steel because the government is giving more impetus to infrastructure. Housing for All is a massive housing scheme, and also with the interest rates that are coming down slowly because the money has come back to banks now. The money which was there earlier in bedroom and bathroom after November 8th has come to bank. Whether demonetization is good or bad, iska fayda kya hai, aur achhi tarika se isko amal kar sakte the, kya iske bare mein charcha ho rahi, hone dijiye, hote rahega. Mera kahana simple, paisa jo bedroom mein, bathroom mein, pillow ko niche the, wo paisa bank mein pahunch gaya, pata ke saath pahunch gaya, pita ke saath pahunch gaya, pati ke saath bhi pahunch gaya. Usme kitna safed hai, white hai, kitna black hai, kitna fair hai, kitna rough shear hai, number one kya hai, number two kya hai. वो सब रिजर्व बैंक का काम है. जल्द से जल्द रिजर्व बैंक भी वो काम पूरा करके लोगों को बताए क्या स्थिति, वो उनका दायित्व तो बनता है. मेरा कहना है बैंक में पैसा है, लोन देने के लिए बैंक तैयार है, और देश में इन्वेस्ट करने के लोग आ रहे हैं. पूरा दुनिया भर में मोस्ट फेवरेट डेस्टिनेशन फॉर इन्वेस्टमेंट इज इंडिया. दिस इज नॉट व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, दिस इज नॉट व्हाट दिस मिनिस्टर्स आर सेइंग, दिस इज व्हाट द वर्ल्ड बैंक सेड, दिस इज व्हाट द एडीबी हैज सेड, this is what the International Monetary Fund has said, this is what the Moody's rating, not Modi rating, Moody's rating has said. ye sthiti hai aur desh mein bhi sparda ho raha hai states mein. abhi naya state ban gaya Telangana, Andhra, dono thoda chota ho gaya, fir bhi small is beautiful and they become more dutiful also. If they focus their attention, they are doing it, they do it in a most effective way, they will prosper. When Chhattisgarh was formed, people raised questions, Chhattisgarh mein hai kya, kya hoga, ye sab. आदिवासी इलाका है, ये सब फॉरेस्ट इलाका है, झारखंड कैसा ये पाएगा वगैरह। अभी देखो आज अभी यहाँ बैठे हुए हमने रिपोर्ट देखा, गुजरात छत्तीसगढ़ एंड हरियाणा, ये हरियाणा और गुजरात छत्तीसगढ़ दोनों छोटा स्टेट्स है, दे ग्रू फास्टर बिटवीन 2013 एंड 17 क्रिसिल स्टडी दे हैव रिकॉर्डेड द फास्टेस्ट इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ रेट्स बिटवीन 2013 एंड 17 अकॉर्डिंग टू स्टडी रेटिंग बाय क्रिसिल। देर इज अ कॉम्पिटिशन, यस द प्राइम मिनिस्टर सेड स्टेट एंड सेंटर मस्ट वर्क टुगेदर, दे मस्ट वर्क एज टीम इंडिया इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ पॉलिटिकल डिफरेंसेस। यस देर विल बी डिफरेंसेस, वी आर huge country, 130 crore population, we have different regions, but at the same time we should all think in terms of as a nation, nation first, party next, self last, that should be the attitude, and then not getting too much into politics, center and state must work together whether they belong to same combination or not. The reason is people want development, the younger generation, their aspirations are very high, and as I told you, the world is looking towards India. World is looking towards India. Today, earlier, you know, it used to be red tape. Now it's red carpet. Ease of doing business, ease of approvals, ease of permissions, and then using IT for the welfare of the people, reducing corruption, reducing middlemen, and then moving towards digital. Everything should be on the, and the coming days, everything should be online. Otherwise, you'll be in line forever. ऑनलाइन में होना चाहिए, एप्लीकेशन ऑनलाइन, सैंक्शन ऑनलाइन, दैट शुड बी द लाइन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। द एंटायर कंट्री शुड थिंक इन दिस टर्म्स, कंट्री ऑफ इंडिया साइज विथ ऑल मिनरल्स, विथ ऑल रिसोर्सेज, विथ ऑल ह्यूमन नॉलेज, व्हाई वी आर यू लैगिंग बिहाइंड, व्हाई यू लैग्ड बिहाइंड ऑल दिस इयर्स, दिस हैज टू बी थॉट ऑफ, एंड दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ NMDC वेयर दे हैव डन अ ब्यूटिफुल ग्रेट वर्क, दैट शुड बी एन एग्जाम्पल टू अदर्स, इफ यू वर्क हार्ड यू कैन एक्सेल। Hard work pays, commitment pays. Friends, I can tell you with all pain, before Britishers came to India, India's wealth was 27% of the world GDP was contributed alone by India. 27% of the world. Today, we are struggling to reach 7%, 7.5, 7.8. And every 2 years, we will reach 10%. Some people are thinking. So that was the country, but this unfortunately, I said yesterday, unfortunately also, every time Dick and Harry came and attacked us, they ruled us, they ruined us, they cheated us, they looted us, they have taken away much of our wealth. While going away, they have taken away some of our brains also. That colonial thinking, now we should come back, we should remember our roots, we must all dedicate ourselves to the cause of the nation, we must think about the society. We must also get into all these movements, that whether it is Swachh Bharat, whether it is Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, whether it is encouraging agriculture, whether it, all these things, it's not one party program or one person's program. It's all our responsibility. Everything will be done by the government. Hum kya karna? Ghar ke saamne Hyderabad mein kisi ke ghar mein, ghar ke saamne kaudang aaye to, arre sir corporator aaya nahi, so corporator aake clean karega kya usko? Mantri ji kahan gaye? Ye इसका वो और कोई, ये जनता का दोष नहीं है, ये हमारा दोष है, राजनेताओं ने हमारा, मैंने कल तक मैं भी राजनेता था, अभी नहीं हूँ, मैं राजनीति में नहीं हूँ, आई एम नाउ रिटायर्ड फ्रॉम पॉलिटिक्स बट नॉट टायर्ड फ्रॉम पब्लिक लाइफ, इसलिए मैं थोड़ा रुचि ले रहा हूँ इन विषयों में। हम लोगों ने लोगों का मनस्थिति ऐसा बनाया, सब काम सरकार करेगा, हम बेकार बैठे तो चलेगा, ऐसा नहीं चलेगा। पीपल हैज टू इन्वॉल्व, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर सिटी, डेवलप हैदराबाद, people also should involve, and the government's work is, I am telling you, to public sectors and also to governments, is have, please have transparency, paradarshakata, please have accountability, then only people will have confidence in you. The dashboard now we have inaugurated, everything should be known to the people, this is how much production, this is how much expenditure, this is how much salaries, this is how much income, and this is what we are doing, everything should be known to the people. Then there should be accountability. The accountability was lacking in certain public sector undertakings earlier. Whether we work or not, everything is assured. That was the feeling. But other public sectors like NMDC and other ONGC, many of these things, they were working hard. That's why there. gaining. There may be some mistakes of the government policies also, I don't deny, at different times. But at the end of the day, if there is transparency and if there is accountability, people will support you. This has been my experience of last 40 years in public life. So friends, what I want to suggest on this occasion is transparency and accountability are important. The NMDC is focusing on that. They must also go for new innovative methods. The world is changing. We are all living in LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. You will have competition. You can't leave it. And then just now I was telling Mr. Madhusudan, see, competition mein kya hai? For Tata, phir baad mein JSW, phir baad mein Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. I told him next time he must jump further. Jump money in the work, not otherwise. Competitive spirit hona chahiye. States ke biche bhi competitive spirit hona chahiye. Sparda hona chahiye. Manasparda nahi hona chahiye. Sparda. Misunderstanding nahi hona chahiye. Competition hona chahiye. Competition makes you to work more, to motivate more. I'm happy to know that as part of its diversification and forward integration plan, NMDC is setting up a 3.0 MTPA greenfield steel plant at Nagarnar in Chhattisgarh, which is an advanced stage of construction. This steel plant will bring about much needed development of the entire region of Chhattisgarh and neighboring areas. NMDC has also forayed in pellet making, which is also an environment friendly initiative. Just now minister was telling, I told the minister and I was minister, now of course I am not the ex-minister. I told him that AP Reorganization Act makes a promise that they will explore the possibility of setting up a steel plant in Bhayaram in Telangana and also in Kadapa in Andhra Pradesh. So their studies have been made and studies have been found that they are not viable. Then we had a meeting and we discussed with our Chaudhary Viren Singh Ji and other colleagues also, and then came to the conclusion it has to be studied further. The state and central government has to give certain concessions. And state has more responsibility because land and also the local taxes and all, if they are reduced, then only it will become viable. That was the broad. Then we requested for a task force. Then I insisted, and then minister was kind enough to appoint a task force. The task force also, he was telling me they will complete their work within 10-15 days. Task force ka task forcefully karna chahiye. दबाव डाल के करना ऐसा नहीं कह रहा हूँ मैं. पॉजिटिव आउटलुक होना चाहिए इस इलाके में. या स्टील प्लांट होगा या पैलेट का निर्माण करने का व्यवस्था होगा. क्या हो सकता है गंभीरता से सोच के जल्द से जल्द निर्णय करना. मुझे विश्वास है, मंत्री जी ने भी कहा, मैंने भाषण के पहले भी उनको कहा, मैं उपराष्ट्रपति बन गया मगर यहाँ का तेलुगु वालों को जो हमने वादा किया उसको हमेशा मैं याद रखता हूँ. आप लोगों को याद दिलाते रहता हूँ सरकार में जो है वो. सो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम ऑल्सो हैप्पी that the NMDC has spent 798 crore in the last 5 years on a series of CSR activities. In the coming days also, they must focus more on tribals. They must focus more on backward areas rather than plain areas. That's my suggestion too. The initiatives include creation of an education hub in Dantewada, extending 18,000 scholarships to children from weaker sections, providing free treatment to tribals and deploying mobile medical services in remote villages. Amara Siddhanta Mahatma Gandhi Ji Ambedkar Ji Dindal Upadhyay Ji ne kaha antyodaya, jo antima pankti mein baithe unka uttan. Antima pankti mane ye silpakala kendra mein baithe unka nahi, samaj mein jo antima pankti mein baithe, jo suppressed, oppressed, depressed log hai, jo vanchit log hai, unka uttan pahle hona chahiye. Isliye मैं बहुत प्रसन्न हूँ. 18,000 बच्चों को स्कॉलरशिप देना कोई मामूली विषय नहीं. आने वाले दिनों में भी एनएमडीसी अपना सीएसआर का पैसा बैकवर्ड इलाका में, ट्राइबल इलाका में और फॉरेस्ट इलाके में जो लोग रह रहे वहाँ ज़्यादा खर्च करे तो अच्छा होगा. कॉरपोरेट बॉडीज लाइक एनएमडीसी आर सेटिंग हाई बेंच मार्क फॉर अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू एमोलेट एंड दिस मोमेंटस ओकेशन माई हार्टिएस्ट कंग्रेचुलेशन टू ऑल दोज हु हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ दिस 60 ईयर्स ऑफ जर्नी ऑफ एनएमडीसी एंड आई विश द बेस्ट फॉर मेनी मोर सच ईयर्स टू कम इन द टाइम्स अहेड. आई एम डिलाइटेड दैट द एनएमडीसी हैज बीन स्पेशली अटेंटिव टू द एनवायरमेंटल कंसर्न्स. आई एम टोल्ड दैट द एनएमडीसी माइंस हैव बीन ग्रांटेड 5-star रेटिंग बाय द इंडियन ब्यूरो ऑफ माइंस गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ सस्टेनेबल प्रैक्टिसेस. आई एम ग्लैड to know that NMDC is undertaking pollution control measures and working towards zero waste mining by maximum utilization of various grades of iron ore. I would urge upon the NMDC to continue on its growth trajectory and maximize the national wealth. NMDC, national maximizing the wealth by keeping the interest of the people and the planet. Planet also. As I told you, the country is on the move and all public sector units must introspect, compete with each other, create more wealth. Unless you create wealth, you cannot distribute wealth. You have to create wealth, na? Nenu appudu appudu cheptu untanu. Panchala, panchala ani manavallu chaala mandi arustu untaru gattiga, maadutuntaru, tappu ledu. Panchala, panchala, adi panchala, idi panchala. Panchala ante mundu penchali kada. Penchakunda panchite panchi maatram migulutundi. Andukani dani manandaram kuda drushtilo pettukoni, everybody should focus on creating more wealth so that you can distribute wealth. Without creating wealth, if you distribute wealth, then you will become a pauper. And then you will be debt-ridden state and debt-ridden country. That should not be this thing. Friends, jaisa maine kaha, shuru mein hi mujhe bahut prasannata hai. Aaj main yahan aaya hoon, is karyakram mein bhag le raha hoon, Hyderabad mein. Aur iske liye main mantri ji ko aur unka sahyogiyon ko sabko dhanyawad dena chahta hoon. Aur NMDC management ko bhi धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ जो मुझे जो अवकाश दिया आप सब लोगों से मिलने के लिए और जो पुरस्कार दिया हमने ये पुरस्कार हमारा संस्कार है भारत का जिनके पास प्रतिभा है फेलिसिटेटिंग द पीपल विथ सम मेरिट फेलिसिटेशन इज टू गिव इंस्पिरेशन टू अदर्स इस बार उनको मेडल मिला अगला बार मुझे मिलना चाहिए मैं अच्छा काम करे तो मुझे भी मिलेगा दिस इज द पुरस्कार द स्पिरिट ऑफ पुरस्कार So please try to compete, improve your efficiency, and try to contribute more and more. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind. Andariki. Namaskar.